And we're back. It's awfully quiet. Where's that scary music? Yeah, there's been, quite a lot been going on. The animancy trials are being held in this courtroom, I guess? Council chambers? And now, gotta watch the last episode, really. Thais, what did he do? Throw his soul into this guy and killed the Grand Duke, and then they killed the poor guy, but of course he wasn't the one who did it. He was being controlled by Thais. Now we've got rioters and all that fun stuff.
Time to see and not be seen.
Oh, she's seeing us.
No problem.
So we probably got rioters going on out there. Well, they say that there's rioting outside, so probably gonna get a bunch of battles. We gotta make our way back to Lady Webb and tell her what happened. And we'll see how difficult that is. That whole thing, that whole scene in the courtroom was awesome, by the way. I encourage you to watch it if you haven't done so already. I'm not gonna sneak. So, they call them justiciars. I thought he says justiciar. Stand down, we don't want to fight you. You picked your side, oh. Because I selected them?
That's it!
Well, we helped kill them. They don't, answer. Well, I guess we'll make our way back down. Any new description here? The tower? Wow, we can really see the destruction here. These lot are in league with the Animancers. Take back our city. Dozens martyr. Have to take part in these battles. Well, this is probably going to go on for some time. If we can fight the dozens, I don't really care. That's funny. Alright, Brackenbury, we go. If this was any other game, you know, you have to fight your way completely out and... It's interesting how this game, you don't have to do that. Of course, we don't know what's waiting for us. Animancer's boots grants jolting touch 3 per rest, +3 damage reduction for shock. I'll take those. I think one of us is missing boots. One of us doesn't have boots. Oh no, we actually all have boots. Boots of Zealous Command. Long March. Take off the stealth ones, give Adair these animancy boots. Animancer's boots. Hopefully they won't implicate him in any way. Hello, commoner. Well, of course, they're burning down the sanitarium. Yeah, things are going rather badly. That's funny how we could search that one body. Ah, what's going on here, animancers? Oh, the south curtain wall is done. One, two, three, four, six, seven, eight. Towers? I don't know. Go on, run before they see you.
Greetings.
Dozens of martyrs says I recognize you. You were the one who spoke up at the hearing. What were you just doing? I got a few of the animancers out of the building through the back. A lot of them didn't make it out, though. Aren't you with the dozens? I was. The things I heard at the hearing today, though. He shakes his head. I had it all backwards. If it was good enough for the Duke, it was good enough for me. I don't care if an animancer did kill him. Doesn't mean we gotta hold them all responsible. This, he gestures at the flames behind him, isn't what we're supposed to be about. Very commendable. I have to go. He nods. Get out of sight. Wait this thing out. Good luck, friend. I wonder if there's others who will talk to us, though. I don't imagine the commoner as well. Yeah, let's go. Oh my god, there's people dead in here as well. Right on cue. Oh my god. Well, we'll look for Lady Webb as soon as we loot all these bodies. We have that book. Anyone alive in here?
I can do that. That's settled.
Fine, leather armor, sure, why not?
A simple test.
They don't need that if they're all dead. That's the way I look at it. Yep, stealing. Uh-oh. Lady Webb lies still in her bed, an ornate cushion propping her back upright. The blood pooled beneath a gash in her chest is tacky and nearly dry. Oh no! A shattered glass rests on the floor beneath her dangling hand. You can feel the faint aura of her fading essence in your ken. Aw, man, reach out for it. You make contact and are immersed in a torrent of sensory input and experience. When it calms, you find yourself in the same room, lying in bed with a glass of brandy in your hand. Through the walls from the streets outside come the sounds of screams and shattering glass and the cacophony of an angry mob. You take a sip and it warms your gullet. Across the room, the door opens behind a patient, steady push. Into the room rocks Theos, the floorboards creaking beneath deliberate steps. You wait until the last of the brandy has trickled down your throat before you speak.
I was a fool to think I could tame these people.
You came closer than most.
A fine epitaph.
No worse than any.
You are concentrating, focusing with all of your energy. It feels as though you are diving into a stone wall over and over, but it cracks suddenly, unexpectedly, allowing the vaguest wisp of a thought to leak through.
What's in Twin Elms?
Did you pull that from my thoughts?
I've had time to practice.
Ah.
He walks over to a small table and raises a half-empty brandy bottle to eye level. He seems to approve of the selection and begins to reach for an empty glass.
I was saving that for someone.
Pity. You know this is how it has to be.
He replaces the brandy bottle on the table with care before approaching the bedside. He sits on the edge of the bed next to you. His words come freely, absent of all doubt. He draws a long, curved knife from his belt, smeared with fresh blood. With his left hand, he gently pins your sternum as he raises the knife in the other, its point dangling above your heart.
Prove it.
Theos slips the knife between your ribs and pushes it through. Oh my god, the way they describe it. Layers of tissue separate with brittle, papery stiffness, and blood wells up around the blade. A pulse of reflex causes you to drop your glass to the floor, and you hear it shatter. With the last of your strength, you take his knife hand in both of yours, a question radiant in your mind. For an instant, to your great surprise, the pathway to his mind is left open to you, unguarded, and the answer comes, simple, cataclysmic in its reordering of your thoughts. As Lady Webb, you feel as though you have an answer you've searched for all your life, but in your own mind, her understanding lies just beyond your reach. You look at Thais with the wide eyes of someone seeing for the first time, and draw your last breath as a black, velvety darkness descends over you.
Smoke rises above the city walls in billowing plumes that blacken the sky like a storm. Behind the walls, the riots rage on. Known patrons of Enomancy are forced into hiding as looters ransack their estates and make off with their possessions. Enomancers are torn away from their families and dragged from their homes to be stoned to death in the streets. Word had spread immediately that Duke Avar had been assassinated and that an Enomancer was to blame. The city wasted little time in exacting revenge and little effort into evaluating guilt. In the center of it all, Brackenberry Sanitarium burned. And down the lane, Hodred House, the last bastion of stability in the Deerwood, had fallen silent. Now safely outside the city gate, your path points eastward to Twin Elms, where Thais is bound, for reasons that remain mysterious as the Leaden Key itself.
Awesome. Lady Webb has been slain in her own bed by Thais, but not before she managed to learn where he was headed. She has done me a great favor, one I suspect she was well aware of. New quest, the Assassin at Large. Thais has killed the Duke and Lady Webb and sent Defiance Bay into chaos. But Lady Webb saw where he intended to go next, to the city of Twin Elms. It is there I must go if there is any chance of catching up to him. Wait, I thought we were certain that she did it, knowing we'd see it. Now I wonder if she did that, knowing that I'd see it. So we're back onto Adelwine Bridge. There's a rumor that one of the novitiates has the soul of an Adirian general. Crucible Knights have been warning everyone to stay out of the catacombs. They're not safe anymore. The floods have receded. Finally, even the villagers are better than this. My home is in flames back there. How could this happen at Defiance Bay? Gotta laugh now and then, right? I don't want any trouble from you, alright? Alright. We can't enter. Oh, ain't that something? We can't enter Defiance Bay now. Can't go that way either. Did you hear that racket coming from the keep? Must have been quite the drill. Huh. As you cross the bridge, Aloth draws up beside you. The fires of Defiance Bay cast a shivering, flickering light across one half of his face. The other is in darkness.
Please stop. I need to tell you something.
Go ahead.
I have not been entirely honest about my motives for traveling with you up to this point. When I finished my training in Adir, I was introduced to an organization. All I knew was that they were opposed to the unchecked spread of Enomancy, and that they could guarantee me postings far away from the Seathwood, my father and his Earl. At that time, it was enough. In the early years, I thought of them as many things. Hooded men, prudent teachers, the Leaden Key. Their rules were strict, but their guidance was clear. I sincerely believe they wanted to keep Kith from the folly of their own foolish ambitions. I came to the Deerwood a little over a year ago. My orders were to gather information on animancy in the region. A senior contact met with me every few months to receive my reports and issue new leads. She sent me to Gilded Vale to keep an eye on events surrounding the local lord, but I lost track of her shortly after that. I don't know if she was reassigned, killed, or sacrificed the way you saw. By the time you met me, I'd been on my own for a couple of months.
What did you want from me?
I needed some kind of direction. After that scrape with the locals, I was ready to get out of town. But then you mentioned the hooded figures and the machine, and I was sure you were on the trail of the Leaden Key. And I was correct, in a way. What we found wasn't what I expected. I knew the Leaden Key was trying to stop animancy, but I didn't realize how far they'd gone. Murder, sabotage, abandoning entire districts to shambling horrors. And now the whole city is up in flames. I'm still not sure about animancy, but I know I've been following the wrong master. Please, accept my apology and my service. Let me fight with you to stop Theos.
We need you, Aloth, of course.
And what do you really expect us to do with this too-late confession? Trust you on your word?
Palagina shakes her feathered head and holds her hands out toward Aloth as though framing him in her view. Well, it is quite a eye-opening thing you've confessed there. Durance isn't going to speak? With all your supposed extra senses, you let this happen? How like a watcher to miss what's right in front of her eyes because she's too busy dancing in the ether. Adara says, I still feel kind of attached, even with the betrayal. He's got this way of taking offense that I really like. Tough one. I forgive you, Aloth, but I want you beside me, not behind me. I'm not asking you to trade one master for another.
That would be an honor.
His voice is solemn and quiet. Before we move on, I'd like to discuss a few things. About your parents. He looks at you cautiously. Yes? I guess I've never talked to him about this stuff before. Why was your mother gone so often? She was invited to join a hemnig with a landed thane when I was very young. His estate was a 5-day ride from our home in the Seathwood, so that was part of it. He gives you the smallest of frowns. The real issue, however, was my father. Despite his initial agreement with the arrangement, father was never happy with it. He would hound and harangue my mother when she was home. He wanted to know whether she was intimate with the thane, and no matter how many times she swore she wasn't, it was never enough. As you can imagine, that led to her coming home much less often, even though she still supported us financially. I think we've been through this. What's a hemnig? A ceremonial marriage between folk and elf. Because the Adir mainland has historically been split between the two races, we have many institutions that are designed to normalize relations. Our monarchy is headed by folk, but an elven consort rules alongside the reigning Faerkoning, or Mequin. This is the most prominent example of hemnig. In many cases, a hemnig allows two households to pool resources. Among the aristocracy, hemnigs consolidate power. Sometimes, as in my mother's case, a hemnig is a means for a noble to add another administrator to his or her household. Consorts are received with almost the same level of respect as their noble counterparts, which can be extremely useful. Of course, hemnigs are sometimes used to sanitize an extramarital affair. He shrugs. I don't know that it's really any better, but it seems to satisfy common notions of decency. And elf and folk unions are sterile, which, no doubt, eases some concerns. Sounds like your father had a problem with his temper. He had a problem with my mother's hemneg, even though they agreed upon it long ago, that the financial benefits would be considerable, that it was little different from his role as Earl Steward, it aided him. And so he drank and raged. When she was home, he raged at her. And when she wasn't, he raged at me. More than anything, he wanted me to become an arcane knight in the service of his Earl. I think he felt this would validate his chosen career and master. He was a firm man, as you saw, but in the end, I became a successful wizard, due in no small part to his strictness. Nonsense. You accounted that on your own, and you would have been fine without him pushing you. Are you so certain? I didn't know what I wanted from my life then. I surely wouldn't have been so focused without a little direction. That's all I really wanted to know. Very well. He looks relieved. So now you understand a little more about Islamir. He wrinkles his nose. No thanks to that animancer. My spleen? Black bile? Come on. Belisege's methods were flawed, but you still learned something, didn't you? Only because you and I have a lick of good sense between us, but the average person? Show them a shiny gadget in the hands of an expert and they'll believe anything. Number 4 is funny. That's true. People are too easily led. Yes, people need something to believe, someone to follow. And the danger of following a bunch of animancers is that they don't even know where they're headed. How exactly did you come to join the Leaden Key? As it is often with such follies, I was young and directionless. The Leaden Key promised some of the structure I was lacking, and they offered me a future far removed from service to my father's Earl. Animancy is possibly even more controversial in Aedir than it is here. The practice has been outlawed for 600 years, but prohibition has a way of breeding curiosity. The success and relative acceptance that animancy has found here and in the Valian Republics spurred a renewed interest in Aedir. The Leaden Key began recruiting more aggressively, and I was in the final period of my training when one of my instructors reached out to me. He shrugs. As I said, it was a welcome departure from my father's plans, and after seeing a few of my colleagues abandon their studies in magic to pursue animancy in the Republics, I was convinced that something needed to be done to stop the spread. That's all. Okay, I have a feeling that talking to anyone would be interesting at this point.
Hmm? If doubts and curiosity plague you, you're skinning your knuckles on the wrong door.
I guess nothing new here.
Hey.
If you kill Thass, I think it's only fair they make you Duke. Got my vote anyway.
Woden was about everything you'd want your firstborn son to be. Dutiful, honest. Put thought into everything he did. Real pain in my ass. Made me look bad about every way he could. It wasn't something he tried to do, but of course that just makes it worse. Not that he didn't get into trouble himself. He was just better about feeling guilty after. But we used to have this farmer near us, Harroward. Couldn't stop talking about how well he cared for his chickens. How their feathers were the whitest in town. Convinced the butcher to pay him double what the other farmers got. Me and Woden got tired of hearing it. I was maybe 11, 12 at the time. We borrowed about 6 different dyes from the dyer one night. Dyed Harroward's chickens every color but white. Next morning, the butcher comes knocking, asking for 6 of his widest chickens. We were feeling great, up until Harroward saw what we'd done. He just got on his knees and cried right there, all those colorful chickens around him not knowing what to make of it. I thought it served him right, but I could tell Woden had other thoughts. Sure enough, the next day, every one of those chickens had been scrubbed down. They weren't white, mind you, but Woden sure tried. Never said a word to me about it, but I knew. That was Woden. My parents, they always let us be who we were. Never told me to be more like him or anything like that. Which was good, because I was never gonna. What's on your mind?
Following your lead. What a mess. The Duke's death was, if you'll forgive me saying it, perfectly timed.
He shakes his head.
Defiance Bay will be a long time recovering.
He fixes a curious look on you. I wasn't sure you'd manage it with Morley there, but I think you had convinced the Duke to side in a sanitarium's favor. It didn't help them much in the end. Not the sanitarium, perhaps, but you made a good case. I think you may have changed some minds in there. When order returns to Defiance Bay, they'll remember what you said. I wasn't done talking to him.
Following your lead.
Looks like there's a clear sky over Heritage Hill. I hope the district can recover. There's a lot of history there, even more so now that you've saved it. Maybe they'll give you a plaque. Actually, this really might do a little something for your reputation. It can't hurt to be known for ending a curse.
It's good to be on the road again. A wanderlust is nothing rare in the people of Rauatai, but often I think myself alone in loving the land as much as the sea. What shall we see next, I wonder?
And Palagina.
I'm ready. Need something?
It's funny how some people have something to say and others don't.
Eh?
Hey.
Adair? Chatting with the commoners?
Eh?
These are... Yeah.
Sure.
I'm not doing that right now. Probably... Talk to them. I mean, we'll explore them already. Yep, we can't select anything in here. That stinks. Go back home. Oh! What? This isn't home. All these names. Can't keep these names right. Cadnua, Cleoban Valag. So, stay tuned for next episode. Gonna rest here, we're all tired anyway. And, we'll be continuing on soon to, Twin Elms. Thanks for watching, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.